Hello everybody, my name is Rahul and in this video we'll be looking at a challenge called Tom Ghost. So the challenge description says that identify recent vulnerabilities to try exploit the system or read files that you should not have access to. So with that, I have spun up the machine and let's copy the IP address and type in rust scan tag A followed by the IP address. Now I went forward and did a research on the topic and turns out Tom Ghost is a name, not only the name of the room but also it is a vulnerability that was found in Apache Tomcat. So I'll tell you what it is, but let's see what we have got here. So as you can see, there is a standard SSH port, a DNS or DNS 53 is for DNS and 8009 and 8080. So 8009 has a specific significance. So if I were to type 8009 port, and as you can see, it is an Apache Tomcat port. So let's just wait and let's just run nmap tag A tag SC tag SV tag P. We'll be running 8009 and 8080 followed by the IP address tag O N. Or just let's leave it. Let's just run it. And you have to do Apache JSERF. So this particular protocol is for JSERF. This particular port is for JSERF and it is a wired protocol. It is an optimized version of HTTP protocol to allow standalone web server such as Apache to talk to Tomcat. So whatever goes through Apache AJP, Tomcat considers it more secure as compared to HTTP, and so it just executes or let it have its way. And this is why there was this vulnerability. So I'll tell you, the name of the vulnerability is Ghostcast. So the description is that if the AJP port is exposed, Tomcat might be susceptible to Ghostcast vulnerability. And yes, it is exposed, which is 8009. Here's an exploit. And as you can see, it also gives us the name of the exploit. Ghostcast is a local file inclusion vulnerability, but somewhat restricted. Only files from a certain path can be pulled. Still, this can include files like webinf/webxml. This can leak important information like credentials for the Tomcat interface depending upon the server setup. Alright, so the particular version that we're talking about is the patched versions are 9.0.31, but let's see which is our version. 8080 is the standard port, as you can see, for the HTTP, and the version is 9.0.30, and the version just above 30 is 31, and it was patched in this version. So we are looking at a vulnerable version of Tomcat, and as you can see, we do not have any admin or login page. So if I were to click on manager, it will say that I have access denied. Again, it will throw us a 403 error. I do not have access to any of these. So this means I cannot even try to brute force the credentials. But let's see, because we have the exploit ready over here, let's just copy it. MV downloads MV482, let's copy it to exploit.py and let's just try to run it, or let's just try to see what it does. Again, this is quite a big file, so let's just do one thing, let's just run it. Python 3 exploit.py. As you can see, the usage is tag P, as the vulnerable version or the port is to be supplied of EJP or AJP, so it is going to be 8009, as we just saw that this is the port number 8009 followed by the IP address. Okay, so it gives us an error, make file got an unexpected keyword argument bug size, and you might also get this. But if you were to use Metasploit, you will not get this. So socket.makefile python. So you can use it with the help of Metasploit as well, but I am trying to manually exploit it. Makefile. So let's just see what are the arguments that it accepts. Mode R, buffering none. So it was buffering none, but he had set it to buff size. So let's just change it to buffering. The line is 295. Is it 295? No. Line is 262. And buffering. So now let's just try to run it. So expected str instance bytes found. So what this gentleman is trying to do is he is appending bytes, but he cannot append byte, he can only append string. So let's just try to, and then let's try print data, and this is going to be an object. So let's just say L is equal to data dot or again nothing, x for x in data, and let's just print it this time, print L. Again, we get an object. Okay, let's just do dot data. And as you can see, it does run. And we get welcome to Ghostcat. Towards the end, if you see, it says welcome to Ghostcat. And this is the user credential. The reason I'm not including T is because I tried it using T, but it did not match. So the name or the common sense says that it is going to be Skyfuck, and this is going to be the password. So nano writeup.txt cat writeup. So just copy this. SSH at the rate this, yes, let's just copy this, paste, we are in the machine. So again, these are encrypted files, so this is supposed to be an encrypted file, and this is the, I suppose, the private key. So let's just type in file everything. As you can see, this is data, and it is supposed to be data because it is encrypted. And triagme ASCII text with CRF line terminator. So I'm guessing that this is going to be key. Yes, this is a key. So since the encrypted file is PGP, so we'll be using GPG tag import, because we have to import the file. The import the file is triagme.asc. This is the private key. And let us type in GPG tag decrypt. And credentials was the file. So this is the problem with this file. So this private key has been encrypted. So for that, I need a private key or the passphrase to decrypt it. So what I did was I went to TryHackMe and just clicked on start attack box. The reason I did this is because there are two ways in which you can, or there is a way in which you can decrypt this file. It is by using John, but John the Ripper does not work on my laptop. So what I did was I went to start attack box and decrypted there. So I have the screenshot with me. So as you can see, so first what I did was I tried to find GPG to John, because John will not accept any file, any private file. What it will do is, first you have to supply John a file which it understands. So what I did was I tried to find GPG to John converter, because as you can see, this file is GPG or PGP. So it is PGP, so I'll have to decrypt it using GPG. So I tried to look at GPG to John. So had it been an SSH private key, you would have had to look at SSH to John, but this is a PGP file. So I tried to give it the file, which is tryhackme.asc. As you can see, this is the file, this is the private file or the private key. I tried to fetch it and I redirected the output to John PHP. So what I the next thing that I do is I'm looking if this the file exists, and it does exist. And then what I did was I typed in John, the name of the key, or the key, yeah, the name of the key, and the word list. So the word list that I used here was RockYou, and as you can see, the password got decrypted and the password is not visible, but I have it written somewhere over here, cat cracking.txt, and the password is Alexandru. So let's just copy it, paste it over here, and as you can see, we get another username. So su Merlin, and let's just type in the password, and we are entered as Merlin. So Merlin ls cat user.txt, and let's just paste it over here. And as now all we have to do is escape privileges. So let us just type in sudo tag l, and as you can see, we can run zip file as root. So what I'll be doing is I'll be going to gtfo bins and let's type in zip. So this is where I get, so I can run the file as sudo. So I'll be using this exploit. And we are root. So cd root cat root.txt. This was really easy. So thank you guys. This is